The boss always gets excited when a Hall of Fame QB joins the show.
I love, love.
Dan Fouts gets under center for DP.
There's a lot going on behind the scenes there.
The CBS analyst joins the show to talk pigskin with the boys.
OMG, G-O-D, LOL.
Does the Oregon alum see his Ducks winning the national title? That's coming up only on the Dan Patrick Show.
Dan Fouts, Hall of Famer, NFL on CBS analyst, Oregon Duck, all of the above. He joins us now. Hi, Dan. How are you?
Good morning, Dan. Good to be with you.
If I was going to say, let's put in a football movie person into the Pro Football Hall of Fame, who would you single out and say, you know what, they would be worthy going in?
Well, the greatest defensive player in a movie ever has to be Bobby Boucher in The Waterboy.
was he sort of like Polamalu before Polamalu?
He was Polamalu, Ray Lewis, Deacon Jones, you name it. He was everybody.
When you watch Brady, can you assess and say, you know what, that's, he does that better than me? As a Hall of Fame quarterback, do you allow that to happen, or is there still that competition to say, you know what, I could run that same system as well as he does?
Well, I'm 59 now. I think I'd have a little bit of trouble doing that. But, you know, I give it a shot at $40 million a year. You bet. Give me a helmet.
But what does he do better than you?
well, I've got one thing he'll never have, though, Dan.
What's that?
Bills.
You've been working on your material, haven't you?
No, you're just easy, that's all.
Your Oregon Ducks, it's not the offense. Do they have defense? If you're looking at Cam Newton, and I'm going to ask you about his pro potential, but when you see this game with your alma mater, what's this game come down to?
It comes down to stopping Newton, and if you look back at the Rose Bowl last year, the Ducks had all kinds of trouble with Terrell Pryor,
yep,
of Ohio State, and Newton's better than Pryor, and so that worries me, but I think this defense is better too. They're very good when you get down close to the goal line. They have an ability to make plays. They're probably a little bit underrated as far as people around the country think because the offense is so good. But Newton is awesome.
But can you look at what you think he'll be like when he gets to the pros, given his style?
Well, he's big, you know, I think he's, you know, the first comparison physically that comes to mind is Jamarcus Russell. And I think we'll stop right there as far as that comparison. But I like the way he throws the ball. I like his movement. I like his competitiveness. And he's so big and so fast. He's unbelievable.
Yeah, he reminds me size-wise in the pocket of Roethlisberger, but the how he maneuvers, it's different, somebody that size to be able to run that well. Right? I mean, when's the last time Vince Young was like that in college in similar size, but he doesn't run like that in the pros.
No, I think somebody got to Vince Young and told him not to run like that as he did in college. But I like your comparison with Roethlisberger because he is huge. He does extend plays. But I think Newton's got more speed and he's more willing to go down the field with his legs.
Would you take a chance on? Is he a top five pick?
I think so, yeah. I think he's a player that you could develop. I wouldn't play him right away, though. But that's the way it is in the NFL now. Is that you draft these kids, you pay them all this money, the fans demand to see them, and the owners want to see them too.
But if you have that rookie salary cap, though, Dan, now you have a chance to sit them and let them absorb the NFL life as opposed to being thrown in there.
Yeah, the cap is there, but the fans still want to see him. I mean, wouldn't you want to see him if you were a fan of a team that drafted Cam Newton?
Yeah, well, same with Andrew Luck. Who would you rather have right now?
Well, I like Luck a lot, and I think that his being taught by Jim Harbaugh has really helped him, plus his dad, and playing in that pro-style system at Stanford. I think Luck is a good shot to go high in the draft and to play immediately and to play well.
Could you see a package deal? Let's say Carolina, if you make a change and you say to Jim Harbaugh, look, we got the number one pick. You're our coach. We want you to bring in your quarterback.
Yeah, I like that better for San Francisco, to be honest with you. I know that San Francisco doesn't have the number one pick, but I might trade for it just to get that package. It would remind 49er fans of Bill Walsh and Jim Plunkett and all the great Stanford quarterbacks. And, for San Francisco, they need that type of that pickup.
Have fun with the Jets and Dolphins this weekend. Thanks for joining us, Dan.
Thanks for having me on, Dan.
All right, Dan Fouts, CBS Sports. Man, he was knocking him out of the park there. I was pitching BP to him. Got some Oregon Duck swag. What's up with you, girl? They sent us some gear here. Coffee mugs and shirts. Some good stuff there. Yes, Paulie.
We don't root. We're rooting for a great national title.
Well, no, if Auburn sends stuff, we'd be more than happy to put it in the man cave.
Is there a good band out of Auburn, Alabama that we could kind of latch on to?
Well, Jack White of the White Stripes, you know, all I do is hear what a big fan he is and that he wants to come on the show. Jack, if you're afraid, buy a dog. We want you to come on. Talk about your love of the Auburn Tigers. This is what I was told. Jack doesn't want to come on and jinx them before the SEC title game. Now what? He doesn't want to jinx them before the national title game? Jack, you're welcome to join us. Talk about your love for the Auburn Tigers. And if you have some swag there, we'd be more than happy to put it up in the man cave here. Speaking of swag, the gift bags for the... I love looking at these. Because, you know, the amateur athletes need some swag. The bowl experience here. We'll let you know some of the great bowl games to go to for what the players get. We'll do so next. Your phone calls. Maurice Jones-Drew will join us in about 40 minutes from now on the Dan Patrick Show.